Today's episode of Financial Sense aims to improve the financial literacy of retirees and would-be retirees by understanding the financial concepts, services, and options that will empower them to make informed and judicious choices, decisions, and actions to enjoy their retirement and improve their financial well-being for the rest of their life. Our hosts and resource persons will talk about the importance of planning in preparation for a comfortable and stress-free life through an effective balancing of savings, pension versus expenses and needs versus wants. How do retirees fare when it comes to saving and preparing for the future?
Welcome to our program, Financial Sense. And today we tackle an important topic which will interest those who are retired, about to retire, and who still have a few more years to retire. I am Elena Pernia, your host for today, and together with my partner here, finance professional par excellence, Alfredo Pascual.
Thank you, Neni. And I would like to greet our viewers a good day. Our episode will explore how those currently working and those with still several years to go before retirement can save for retirement, and what's next for employees after retirement.
Do you know that in reality, a lot of people do not prepare for retirement? And very often, it's seen as a decrease in income rather than the reward that it should be. Also, in the Philippines, you know, children are expected to care for their aged parents when they have retired. But now, some Filipinos are deviating from this norm. There are the lucky ones who have prepared so well that they have their own personal savings, pensions, and assets that can provide them the spending money that they need when they are no longer working.
Well, that's definitely true about children taking care of aging parents. But as a not really aging parent, but as a parent, I don't want to bother my children for taking care of me on my retirement. Well, some people get to enjoy a restful life after retirement. Most people continue working to earn more because the benefits after retirement are not enough for day-to-day expenses of their families. That is why we have invited resource persons who will give retirees guidance on possible sources of income. Also, this will give current employees ideas on how to better plan for retirement. So let me begin the introduction of our important experts in the field of retirement. First is the officer in charge of GSIS Quezon City Branch Office, Mr. Noel Alvarez. We would like to welcome to the Assistant Vice President for Media Affairs of Social Security System, SSS, LUISA Paraga Sebastian, Louis for short. Welcome.
And we are also thankful that the President of the Federation of the Senior Citizens Association of the Philippines, or FSCAP, Mr. George Banal, has agreed to join us today. Also, we will be hearing about RA 9505, or the Personal Equity and Retirement Account, or PERA. So for this, we welcome Mr. Mark Reyes. Let's begin with Mr. Alvarez, with Noel. What advice can you give retirees so that they can better manage their pension and retirement money?
So our prospective retirees should have knowledge or equipped with the different options or the retirement laws that GSIS manage, like what are you qualified for the RA 8291 or the GSIS Act of 1997? Are you qualified for the refund of retirement premiums, what we call the take-all, or the RA 1616, the 7699, or the portability law, or the PD1146 and RA660. So that is like what Ma'am Nenny said, some of the retirees are not aware or not planning for their retirement, but we encourage everyone that they you should be equipped with the different knowledge or the laws we are managing.
Wow, that's a long list of many Republic Acts of different numbers. Now, how do you get your GSIS members understand, you know, what these laws are all about and how they can benefit as GSIS members?
So we at the GSIS are inviting our prospective retirees for a pre-retirement seminar. In that pre-retirement seminar, we discuss detailed the different retirement laws, including the options like if you avail of RA8291, we have two options. The first option is the 5-year lump sum and pension after 5 years, and the second option is the 18 months cash payment and the immediate pension. So also, we are giving them tentative computations of their benefits. And also, we are inviting a resource speaker from Philippine Insurance, Philippine Deposit Insurance Corporation, or the PDIC, wherein our resource speaker from PDIC is giving them knowledge on how to better manage their pension.
Of course, we have to tell our audience that GSIS has government workers as members.
Yes.
Okay. Now, for those working in private companies or the private sector, I'd like to call on Louis of SSS to explain how it is for the private employees.
SSS is probably the cheapest form of saving for your retirement. It only takes a member to remit 120 months of contributions. And it does not mean continuous contributions. You can like have contributed when you have income and then come back to the system when you are actively employed again or if you have other sources of income. We have different classification of members. We have those who are employed in the private sector, those who we call self-employed or earning on their own. And then we also have voluntary members who at one time or another left the system. Probably they are OFWs or overseas Filipino workers. And they came back to the system after a while and decided to contribute again. There is only one computation or there's only one formula for computation of pension under the SSS. So unlike the GSIS, which has several laws that, well, other than the portability law anyway, the pension computation of SSS is basically there are two factors that we consider. Only the credited years of service or the number of years that you have credited to the system and the monthly salary credit. This is where the contribution rate is applied, not necessarily a contribution. So our monthly contribution is anywhere from 110 pesos to the maximum of 1,760 pesos. And for that amount, you already get disability, you already get six types of benefits, and pension is transferred 100% to the surviving spouse or to the dependent children.
Can I be a member of both the GSIS and the SSS?
Yes, ma'am. You will be classified as probably self-employed. Have you worked in a private company before?
No, I've been a government employee for most of my life, but I do have some consultancies.
Then that would count. That would count po. We have a lot of GSIS members now who are contributing to SSS on a voluntary capacity. And then they get two pensions when they retire.
Ah, I see. So, yeah, so two is definitely better than one.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
I don't think we've heard about the benefits available from GSIS. Can you just give us a quick rundown? Pension, of course, there is.
We have,
and then the cash benefit.
We have pension. If you are in the service, if you have a total length of service of at least 15 years, definitely you are a pensioner, a GSIS pensioner. For cases of those with 3 years but less than 15, you will be entitled for what we call the cash payment. Cash payment, if you are 60 years old on the day of your separation, you get it immediately, the cash payment. However, if you are less than 60, again, 3 years, you are in that government service for at least 3 years but less than 15, and you are less than 60 on the time of your separation, you will get the cash payment when you reach the age of 60. That's the difference. If you are already 60, you get immediately the benefit.
Please correct me if I'm wrong, but I actually still have a few more years before I reach mandatory retirement age. But I have wanted to retire already. Would you counsel me? Would you advise me to take an early retirement?
You have an option, ma'am. If you reach the age of 60, you are already entitled for what we call the optional retirement. If you want to enjoy, if you want to choose a five-year lump sum, you mean your computed basic monthly pension times 60, you'll get it on a guaranteed period, then pension at age 60. And if you want to have that option two, wherein most of our retirees are getting the option two. Why? Because option two seems to be you are still in the government service, meaning you get the 18 months cash payment, 18 months of your basic monthly pension, and you receive pension on the day of your retirement, meaning you receive it monthly, and you are, even though you are in abroad, if you are at the home, you receive a monthly pension without tax. Then that's better option. And most, as I mentioned, most of our retirees are availing of the option too, which is the immediate pension.
So I can enjoy earlier than necessary. Okay,
yes,
good.
Ma'am.
I think that's good advice. Thank you very much.
Welcome, po.
So we've seen how GSIS and SSS can help our retirees, particularly senior citizens. And we have here, of course, he was introduced earlier, Sir George Banal from FSCAP, who is very much involved in assisting senior citizens in their retirement. George, would you like to share with us?
First and foremost, I'd like to thank SSS because the much-awaited and the long-delayed 2,000 pesos pension hike has at long last been given to us. Retroactive yun eh. So January, February, and March, we received 3,000 pesos, and the balance of the 2,000 peso increase will likely be given 5 years from today. So, pinakikiusap namin na sana, medyo wag naman kwan, baka marami na sa amin ang patay. I felt guilty because I could have been a pensioner of both. I served the Quezon City Council for 13 solid years as a city councilor. And I have known about the portability law, but I sort of forgot to avail of it. So, it's a pity. Because SSS has been good to me, but what I receive is not really sufficient. You know, the Philippine Constitution mandates that the family should take good care of the senior citizen. Okay. But, you know, with 8 children, kami naman independiente because during my younger years, I was a salesman and a marketing man, so I saved for the future. Meron akong trust fund. Pero I did not really plan for retirement. Yan ang akin. Mari pa ba kung maging pensioner ng GSIS with my 13 years of service?
As mentioned, sir, if you are at least 15 years, you will be a pensioner. For the case of for your case, it's only 13, so I think we paid you a cash payment.
I received the cash payment, but when I retired from the City Council in 2004, dapat siguro nag-voluntary
to continue.
To continue. Because you had the years in the private sector.
That's right.
Which should have been added, you know, under the portability law that you referred to
earlier.
So I guess, you know, for those of you out there who are in a similar situation, please remember, it's 15 years.
For GSIS?
Yes.
For GSIS, SSS, only for 10 SSS years.
It's only 10 years. So, but if you have got 13 years working in government, well, then you can continue when you reach the 15-year minimum. Is that correct?
Or you add up your years in the private sector.
May I make additional comments? So at my age, I'm past 70, I still work. And because of my inadequacy in GSIS, I maintain a trust fund. And now we have a law, we call it Anti-AIDS Discrimination in Employment Act. Under this law, even if you are past 60, you can still be employed. Wala na yung mga advertisement, below 40 years old. As a matter of fact, Quezon City has been employing about more than 400 senior volunteers, paying them regular pay, and also business establishments like SM malls. They employ, you know, traffic aides, greeters. And so, we senior citizens are still qualified to work for as long as we are mentally and physically capable.
Well, there is this statement that the new 30 is 60, or maybe it's the other way around. 60 is the new 30, so you can start work, still work, and while benefiting from that senior citizen card.
Now, ma'am, if I may, obsolete na yung life begins at 40 because today, life begins at 60.
Okay. So, you heard that.
I agree.
You heard that. Life really begins at 60. You have double citizenship when you reach 60.
Well, George referred to managing a trust fund. Maybe we should now go to our fourth guest to tell us about Pera.
Yes.
This is a way by which
you can volunteer.
People can voluntarily build up a retirement fund.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Mr. Reyes,
yes, sir. Yes.
Mark, please explain this.
Actually, the Pera is mandated by Republic Act 9505 or the Personal Equity and Retirement Account Act of 2008. But the implementing rules were only released by the BIR in 2016, actually in the first half of last year. Mm-hmm. And this, the law or the implementing rules and regulations required banks, like the big banks, to create this product, which is actually a voluntary account where investors or employees can complement their GSIS and their GSIS and SSS pension funds. And they can do this, they can contribute every year for a maximum of 100,000 pesos. They can do that. For OFWs, they can contribute up to 200,000 pesos. And the funds that go into this account, they get to choose where to invest it. There's a menu of financial instruments where you can, or investment vehicles where you can put your funds in. And with that in mind, what is the benefit from that? You get tax credits. So for every amount of funds that you put into the account, you get an equivalent of 5% tax credits, which you can use against your
taxes payable
next in the following year. Yes.
So that's a new scheme that has recently been made available.
They say that it's
to us
patterned after the USS 401 case.
Yeah, the 401k system in the U.S., that's right.
May I ask a few questions about that one? I heard that there's kind of informal age limit to avail of pera.
Actually, in order to avail of pera, there are two things only that requires you to be that there are only a few two things that you should have. First is you should have the capacity to contract, and then secondly you should have a thin. So if you have
no
those
age
two things
considered.
Considering the term capacity to contract, yeah. It's just
no, I mean on the upper end.
On the upper end, actually, I have to mention this. The only time you can redeem the funds that you've invested in a pera is the keywords are 5 and 55. So after 5 years worth of contribution and at the age of 55, that's the only time you can reclaim your...
But anytime after 55?
And anytime after 55, yes.
I see. So you could take it out even if you're 60?
Yeah, like George still earning. At more than age 70, so you can still establish a pera account.
You do not need the funds yet. You can keep it there and let the funds grow. And after a few years, if you feel like you want to claim some of the funds, you can do so.
So take it when you want to enjoy it.
Yes. And if you want to actually avail of a pera, you can go to... actually, there are two accredited pera administrators. You have BDO and BPI.
I see.
So it also has a maximum of 100,000, right? 100,000 pesos.
For Filipino residents, for OFWs,
annually.
The maximum is 200,000 pesos annually. Yes.
Annually. SSS has a similar separate regular retirement option. It's called the SSS Peso Fund. It's a personal equity savings option fund. It's offered to members 55 years old below. And it also has the same features. You can only invest up to 100,000 a year. Yes.
What's
and it's
for
because
that?
You know, one of the limitations of the SS law, which right now is it has a maximum monthly salary credit of 16,000, meaning no matter how much you're earning, you can only contribute to as much as only 16,000. So right now, most of the investors in our peso fund are BPO young people age 34. So the financial literacy in terms of retirement is already there. And it's good if they have other options because, again, that's also one of limitations of ours in that personal equity savings option fund. It's what they're asking, why is it only 100,000 annually? Because precisely, of course, there are also other, we would also like to support our financial institutions.
So are you saying there's a maximum monthly pension that you pay from SSS?
There's a maximum monthly salary credit to where our contribution rate
means
is applied for.
That determines the highest pension.
Yes.
And how much is that?
Right now, the highest pension is at 17,000 pesos.
17,000. GSIS has no limit, isn't it? It's limited by the actual salary of the retiree and by the salary standardization law, I suppose.
You know? Yes, that's right.
So that's why my mother's pension, who was, and she worked in government, was much higher than my father's pension, who worked in the private sector.
It all boils down to the contribution that you remitted to the system.
But if they say that, you know, people in the private sector earn more than those in the government service, then they will have excess funds to invest in
true.
Pera.
Yes. True.
Okay, and that's how they build up their their pension.
Right. The contribution is 11% on SSS and 21% on GSIS.
Yes, a lot. Yeah.
So it's bigger fund. And GSIS is a much bigger pension fund.
Well, you heard it from our experts today. It's not just one, not just two. There could be three and even more. So consider that while you are still working and maybe when you have reached retirement age and are beyond it, you can have a lot more to enjoy.
Yeah, so our discussion now is really for those who are still actively working and thinking of eventually retiring in the future. When I say retiring, no longer working, okay, and how they can prepare for that time. Do we have any final words from our guests?
Yan. Isa po itong panawagan sa aming lahat ng SSS members. Ang inyo pong kontribusyon, bagamat po ito ay ilang taon nang naibayad po ninyo sa SSS, hindi po iyon nawawala. Kaya anumang oras na gusto niyo pong magbalik sa pagbabayad sa SSS, kayo po ay welcome na bumalik po sa inyong pension system para po pagdating naman ng panahon, kayo po ay makikinabang sa mga benepisyo ng SSS.
Sa GSIS naman.
Okay, una po nagpapasalamat kami sa pag-imbita niyo po sa amin dito para masabi rin po namin o makapagbigay kami ng informasyon para sa ating mga prospective retirees kung ano yung po mga options na pwede nila pong i-avail pag nag-file na po, nag-decide na po silang mag-file ng retirement. So, ito po, also ini-invite ko po ang bawat members natin and even our pensioners to visit our website www.gss.gov.ph. Wherein, doon po, mayroon po kami isang bagong feature po o facility na ito pong tinatawag nating GSIS mo, Electronic GSIS Member Online. Kung sabi nga po, kapag selfie, i-Facebook mo, kapag research, i-Google mo, kapag po online membership records, i-GSIS mo. So yun po yung aming isang facility na alam niyo po lahat po ng mga records niyo, even your loan payments, your dividend payments, makikita niyo po dito sa EGSS mo. Hindi na po kayo kailangan pumunta sa pinakamalapit na GSS office para tingnan ang records niyo sa pamamagitan lang po ng tablet, ng iPhone, ng what gadgets natin po natin na pwede na po ninyong makita ang inyong mga records sa GSS. Sa pamagitan nga po ng ulitin ko, e-GSS mo, e-GSS member online.
With walang that, pila. Walang pila doon.
Walang pila.
Wala pong pila. 24/7 po.
Yung tinatanong ko kanina, yung contributions ko ba sa GSIS noong 1969, makikita ko pa dun sa record online?
Makikita niyo po yun, sir. Basta login lang po kayo dun sa GSIS mo. Ang ginagamit lang po natin dyan sa pag-login natin, yung tinatawag po natin business partner number. So para lang din po kayong nagla-login sa Facebook, nagre-register. So mag-register muna po kayo. Then, saka po bibigyan po kayo ng yung password po nyo. Then, pag po na-confirm na po or na registered na po kayo, then, yun na po yung gagamitin yung laging access para anytime po, pwede po ninyong makita yung sinasabi ka po ni President na pwede pong makita niya kung yun pong record niya noong 1969 ay na doon po sa system natin or na-updated. Pero yun naman po, isa rin po yung magti-trigger din. Halimbawa, nakita na view ni sir, wala yung record ko na yon. So yun po din yung magti-trigger din. Makikipag-coordinate po kayo sa inyong agency authorized officer dito po sa UP, for example. Then sila po yung magsasbigay sa ng information sa amin na ito pong services ninyo ay hindi pa naka-reflect sa system namin. And with all supporting documents, ito po ay i-update. Pag na-validate po yan, na talagang dapat i-include as your servicer, yun po ay i-update ng aming, na ating mga kasamahan sa membership department na nandun po sa GSIS Central Office. Sa
yung business partner number, yun ba yung GSIS contract number ko?
Hindi po. Dati po kasi, ma'am, meron tayong pinatawag na yung policy number. Yun po yun yung contract na sinasabi natin. Ngayon po, ginawa na lang po natin siyang tinatawag nating unique business partner number. Is talaga pong ikaw lang po nagmamay-ari nun. So, yun na po yung ginagamit natin as... pero na dun pa rin po naman yung tinatawag natin GSS ID number. Pero we all of our members now have that business partner number as our identity po dun sa system.
So, part ng computerization yan.
Yes, sir. Part po ng ating...
Maring makapagtanong. ang isang tulad ko na 13 years in government service, wala na bang pag-asa na maging miyembro ng GSIS?
Sir, kagaya nga po nung sinasabi niyo, sir, na yung batas po na na pwedeng pumasok pa yung mga 60, kung kayo po ay pwede pa po uling pumasok. Kaso, sa ngayon po, ang batas po natin sa GSIS, siyempre, dapat po hindi na po lalampas ng 65. So, yun po yung kasing compulsory. Kasi kung kayo po ay... Sir, sa ngayon nga po, yun nga po yung ating, sa batas, currently, yung batas po natin, dapat po, you will be in the government, and your age at entry at the government service should be not beyond 65. But if you are like our elected officials, so 64 po sila na elect as mayor, for example, then tuloy-tuloy po yung term nila. Kahit po 70 na sila, basta po walang gap, pwede pa rin po silang maging
mag-contribute. Kaya ko tinanong yun, napag-alaman ko na meron yata kayong kinakraft na isang parang batas o executive order na baka mabigyan ng pag-asa ang mga tulad ko na nakalimot na to take advantage of the portability law. I inquired from GSIS anyway.
Kaya nga yung anti-aging discrimination law, medyo kulang eh. Dahil hindi inalis yung mandatory retirement.
Correct.
So ako talagang bubuin yung batas para sa anti-aging discrimination, dapat walang retirement age.
Yeah. Matanong ko lang, paano kunyari nakuha mo ng mga benepisyo mo? Paano kung nakuha mo na yung pension mo at age 65? Pwede pa ba ito ituloy?
Well, yun nga po. Again po, pag po nakuha nyo na yung benefit, at 65 na po kayo or more than 65 na kayo po, papa, if ever naging consultant po kayo, hindi na po kayo magiging GSS member. Hindi na po kayo pwedeng magbayad ng premiums. Pero halimbawa po, dagdagan ko na lang po. Yung question po, halimbawa, meron ka ng pension ngayon. Nagpe-pension ka na. Pero halimbawa, 61 ka. Yung previous retirement mo in 2003, tapos ngayon, nung mag-60 ka po, pwede nang yung previous services mo for that, nung mag-60 ka, pwede mong makuha yung pension even if 61, 62 nasa service ka pa. Continue, you will be receiving a pension from your services, your previous services. If you are have a chance to re-enter or you are still in the government service in even at the age 65, magkakaroon ka pa ulit, halimbawa na-meet mo po ulit yung 15 years, pwede ka po maging dalawang pension ang matanggap mo sa GSS. From the pension, from the services, first services mo up to 15 years, then upon re-entry, and upon compulsory retirement at age 65, you still have another 15 years, you get another pension. So you have two pension from the GSS.
Okay yun, kakasabi lang natin kanina, di ba? 60 is the new 30. So, pwedeng-pwede pala.
Like Sir George.
Sa SSS po, nagbabayad po kami up to, on average, 24 years of pension. Ah, gayan po ang talagang proof.
Age limit sa SSS.
Gayan po ang proof talaga na the Tito George, that 60 is the new 30.
Life begins at 60.
Pwede naman pa sa 65 sa SSS.
Ganito po yon. Sa amin po, ang last age na pwede pong maging membro ng SSS, first time member, 59. Kasi po, again, yung optional age of retirement.
Anong age ka pwede ma-maintain yung membership mo?
Basta po, mayroong kayong inihulog, halimbawa, nung araw pa, at gusto nyo siyang balikan. Halimbawa, kahit na po kayo ay 60 years old, pero gusto nyo tapusin. Halimbawa, naka 1 year po kayo nung araw, at para po makasampung taon kayo, need 9 years. So, ituloy nyo lang po yun. Wala pong age requirement para magtuloy ng pension. Patatapusin nyo lamang po yung number of years na 120 months para po makapag-pension na kayo. So even if, kumbawa lang, tapos po kayo na paghulog ng 70, 71 po magpe-pension po kayo monthly. At pwede pong isalin yon sa inyo pong legal na asawa at sa inyo pong dependent children.
Narinig nyo yun, ha? Legal.
Ayun. Yan po, legal na asawa.
Maring sumabat, no? ang life expectancy ngayon ay tumaas ng 10 taon. So baka kailangan amendahan yung mga patakaran nila doon because for us men, ang life expectancy is 68. Hindi naman 69 dahil 68. Sa mga babae is about 72.
Mas mahaba.
The woman always outlives the man. So
the stronger.
Oh, stronger sex.
Mas malakas daw tayo.
Hindi pa natin narinig yung mga detalya ng ginagawa ng FSCAP para sa mga senior citizen. Pwedeng paki...
Maraming salamat ulit, Mr. President. Kami, ine-encourage namin ang mga young ones upon a time to indulge in healthy and active aging. Kami nagkakaroon ng mga orientation seminars, kami pumupunta sa mga probinsya at we orient. Oo. Tsaka, so, hanggat maaari, sana iwasan yung mga bawal. Yung smoking, yung alak, yung pagpupuyat. Naku, ang sama nung nagpupuyat. Tsaka, bawasan yung pagkain ng sobrang mataba. Ngayon, kung gusto nyong hindi umabot kayo ng... O nga pala, meron kaming centenarian's law na binibigyan ng 100,000 ang sinuman na makaabot ng 100 years. Marami nang nakaabot ngayon.
Yung father ko malapit na. 98 na.
Si Mayor Herbert Bautista sa LGU, sa Quezon City, nagbibigay ng 100,000. So on top of that, sa national law, centenarian's law, nagbibigay pa ng 100,000 para sa ganun, 200,000 para sa mga magte-take care nung nakatatanda. So yan ay bahagi sa ginagawa namin at yun na nga, kami naglalabi for bills to be translated into laws so that there will be more benefits and privileges. Ang trabaho ko, I'm the legislative and lobby chairman. So, lagi ako nasa lobby. So, yung mga batas na naipasa, at ngayon, meron pa pinag-uusapan yung elder abuse na hindi lang physical. Yung inaglahi mo, minura mo, nakatatanda, ay, mapaparusahan sila. Oo. Tsaka meron din mga ginagawang batas yung special polling places na in-apply na minsan sa mga malls para hindi na kami pumapanik sa third, fourth floor na pumipila ng mahaba na after 3 hours, yung iba umuwi na, hindi na bumoboto. And perhaps a separate date o sa isang polling place lang kagaya ng ginagawa sa ibang bansa para nga kami ma-encourage na ma-exercise yung right of suffrage.
Ma'am Nenny, kanina binubulungan ako ni Tito George. Sabi niya, ang liit ng pension ko sa SSS.
Piano.
Actually po, when the issue of pension came out, that SSS has very low pension, it was also a wake-up call to everybody. And now the question is, how do we get the highest pension at SSS?
Yes.
So yun po yung naging usapin na sa ngayon, na tinatanggap po lagi ng SSS. At batay po sa batas natin, kailangan po, dalawa po yung tinitingnan, yung monthly salary credit, ibig po sabihin, yung po yung pinag-a-applyan ng inyong 11% na contribution rate, okay. At saka po yung credited years of service, or gano'ng kahaba po kayo nag-ulog with SSS. Yung pong tumatanggap ng 17,000, yung pong maximum, actually, 18,000 na po siya ngayon, dahil nagbigay tayo ng 1,000.
Wow!
So, 18,000 na po yung pinakamataas na pension ngayon sa SSS. Pero sila po, yung mga nagbayad, lagi dun sa maximum monthly salary credit. Ibig sabihin, sila po yung may pinakamalaking contribution lagi dahil tumataas naman po yung ating monthly salary credit. At pagkatapos, on the average po, nagbayad sila sa SSS ng 40 years.
Okay.
So, yan po yung halimbawa nagtrabaho ng 20 anyos at walang putol na nagulog with SSS hanggang 40 years, sila po yung tumatanggap ng 17,000 na 18,000 na monthly pension sa ngayon.
So, mas maraming hulog, mas malaki ang makukuha sa dulo. Whether it is GSIS or SSS, pero that does not apply to pera.
Actually, I was going to add regarding the pera, aside from the tax credits of 5% of the total contribution, you also get to enjoy actually tax shields from income taxes, so capital gains tax, final withholding tax, for your investments. So that's another incentive for pera account holders.
So that means I can use my pera account to deduct from my income tax responsibilities?
No, ma'am. When you invest direct to security, meaning you bought a stock or a bond directly in the secondary market, you are always charged with income taxes,
yes,
capital gains, and whatnot.
Okay.
With the pera account, you are exempted from such taxation. Yes, ma'am.
Mr. President, Ma'am Neni, I would like to ask, add po, yung sa tabi ni Tito George na yung mga centenarian natin, binigyan ng Quezon City ng 100,000. Kami po din sa GSIS, in 2015 po, yung pong lahat ng pensioners po natin na yung pong September 1, 2015 ay 90 years old, binigyan po natin yan ng 30,000. Yung pong 95 years old na mga pensioners, binigyan po natin yan ng 50,000. At yun naman pong mga 100, yes po, nung September 1, 2015 po, yun naman po ng 100 years old, binigyan natin ng 100,000. Then, effective po yung mga, yung lahat naman po na mag-turn ng 90 nung September, starting September 2 of 2015, binibigyan po natin yan ng 20,000. At yung mga 95 po, binibigyan natin ng 30,000. At yung pong nag-100, binibigyan po natin ng 50,000. So, kung talaga po mahalaga na, yun nga po, kanina narinig natin yung isang tinatanong ni Mr. President, ano ang kinakain mo? So, para mahaba yung buhay, so, ano po natin, be conscious din po tayo, so, yung nga, maging, kasi pag mahaba ang buhay, mas maraming benefit. Lalo pa sa GSS na nagbibigay tayo ng tinatawag nating, binanggit ko nga po, na milestone benefit.
Ako gusto kong magdagdag, no, hindi naman sa finances. The key to longer life is being happy.
Yes. Ah, thank you.
Kaya sa ating samahan, bawal yung nakaburangot, nakasimangot. Let us all smile and let us laugh. Merong ang yoga laughter, di ba? You laugh without any reason at all. Kaya lang, kuidaw na nag-iisa ka ba kami dumaan?
Pero dadagdag ko lang na ang importante, hindi lang long life, but productive life. Active life, healthy life. Meaningful life. Well, kaya ako naman nabanggit dito, gusto kong balikan nga yung sinabi na you have to be concerned about health. Because so far, we're talking about income in retirement. We have not talked about expenses. But expenses are among those you manage when you talk about finances in retirement. Medical expenses are among the biggest take on your retirement income. So you have to maintain a healthy life to minimize that cost. So whatever amount of retirement income you have, it will not be sufficient if a big part of it will be spent on maintenance medicine and other medical expenses.
Yeah. So just make sure that the benefits that you get, the happy birthdays that you will get from both GSIS and sometimes from SSS will not go to the doctor, will not go to the medicine, but will actually be yours to enjoy. Is that right?
Yeah, that's the kind of message we'd like to share with our audience. And I'm very happy we had this session. Because through this session, we hope to help not really just retirees, but those planning to retire sometime in their working life. I hope that the information we have shared with you today will be very helpful in your planning a enjoyable, a happy retired life in the years to come.
Yes. We'd like to thank our guests here. Thank you very much, Louis, Tito George, Mark, and Noel. Thank you very much. And of course, thank you, our viewers. We hope that this episode helped you be happy, be healthy, and always think about the future. We hope also that you will watch other episodes of our Financial Sense. Thank you and have a great day.